was totally about to not do a vlog, but then I just started chugging this fucking coffee, and now it's just hitting my veins. And I've been listening to this new Greedo tape, which has actually been out for a few weeks, or maybe like a month. And that means I'm a bad hip-hop fan, bad friend to him, that I haven't been listening to it. But, you know, I'm inspired by this mixtape. I'm inspired by this caffeine. What the fuck? Why not make a vlog? Wait. I want to get fully monetized. I'm going to say, what the f... I'm going to actually try to edit the swears out of this vlog. Or am I? I don't know. Maybe that's just the coffee talking. Either way, I went to bed at 3 a.m., woke up at 8:30, and now I got another long fucking day of meetings ahead of me. Effing meetings ahead of me.
Going to the jeweler, bust the AP, yeah. Sliding on the water like a jet ski, yeah. I'm trying to fuck you on your bestie, yeah. Chop up with this girl, so do not test me, yeah.
Hey, I might be 19 minutes late, but I'm sure Trill Sammy has done you worse, right?
Tori's worse.
Oh, really?
Than Sammy, yeah.
Hey, the more popping you get, the more leverage you got.
Texas.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I'm from here, though.
Where do you stay out here? Your parents' house, you guys in?
No.
Let's go.
Yo, I finally made it, bro.
Gay. Back at the Awesome Shit store for like an hour before my next meeting. What's going on, guys? Mikey Tyra, Dylan Blood, Nate Richter. What's happening? Yeah, nice to see you too. Didn't mean to leave you hanging there.
Let's get this.
What's going on?
We're about to do a photo shoot.
Photo shoot?
Yeah.
Nice. Oh, who's taking the photos?
These two of them.
Oh, you're vegan. Instagram?
Yeah, for the Los Espines.
I need a photo for an interview I just did. I wonder if they're down with an iPhone photo. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Ooh. Okay. About to go to this next meeting at CAA, but I just want to say that this is an underrated classic, this Brandon Vegan vlog from No Jumper Tour Part 1. It contains the Little House Phone Bro Top freestyle and lots of rare Smoke Perp and a little pump footage. And we were just watching it. Like, we don't watch a lot of our old vlogs, but this is such a classic that we just had to go back and revisit it. It was a good era. This was like before clout goggles were like ridiculed as clout goggles. Also, remember when we went to this store and House One spent all his money?
You mean like $5?
Hear me. Big sandwiches.
Where's
everybody based? Alright, so I'm back in the shop. A couple of big meetings over the past couple days with a couple of different agencies. 99% of you don't know what agencies are, don't give a fuck. So I'm not going to bore you with the details and stuff. But basically, like, now I'm feeling really, really good because I feel like my business is now in a place where there's a lot of other people involved. Without ownership, I still own 100% of No Jumper, but a lot of people involved in the management side, the agency side, who over the next couple months are really gonna be sort of taking the lead on different angles of the business and really like making sure that things happen and allowing me to sort of take a step back and just be the artist, the creator, the person who's developing huge amounts of content for you guys on the video side, on the website side. Like, that's gonna be a huge thing. I feel like you guys are all gonna be checking nojumper.com ritually or checking our app very, very soon. We don't have an app yet, but I feel like that's really like the future of this as a media company. And of course, you know, I plan on continuing to do a lot of stuff here on this personal Adam22 channel. But in terms of No Jumper, I just, you know, I need it to be something huge and bigger than myself, and they're gonna help me get there. And I just wanna run a great media company based around, you know, this culture and this scene and this hip-hop shit that I love so much. Anyway, I'm not telling you guys which agency we decided to go with. I don't know, it just feels good to finally start start solidifying myself as part of a bigger thing, so it's not just all on me, where I don't just have to feel like I'm waking up and just hopping on the fucking bike and just pedaling my ass off every single day just to make shit happen. Like, now I'm starting to feel more like, okay, there's other people around me who are going to be making sure that the money comes in, that the opportunities are coming about, while I get to just work on what I love, which is making content for you guys. So, very productive couple of days.
Yo, now what, dick? I'm excited about that. You're a consumer. When there's shit coming out of your butthole.
Yeah.
I eat my own dog food. Like, straight up, like, I deploy patience. 14 of them are a piece of shit. Mm-hmm. But one in every 15 of them, like, fuck, he responded. What does that mean? That fucked with me. What good? I read every single person's reply to your post on Twitter just now about, like, what should I talk to Gary Vee about? Mm-hmm. Right? How big is his dick?
Do you want
to
answer that?
Yeah. Real small. Like, you want to talk about why? Listen, by the way, everybody who's winning is small dicked because they're real insecure and it fucking makes them want to rise like a fucking phoenix. Yeah. He can shake anything he wants. He can shake anything he wants. Really?
Yeah.
Are you on Pornhub?
Yeah.
That's good.
I'm showing my whole ass, my whole dick, everything.
And you killed it?
Yeah.
I really don't give a fuck. I'm not doing stuff for kicks and giggles.
Just worked on my email for a while. Now I'm headed home. I know this vlog is really probably not very long at this point or good, but I guarantee that I'm going to think of something to talk about in the car, and then I'm gonna make this hit the 10-minute mark by talking about something. Alright, I've been here for like an hour on the couch, and my idea was that I was gonna go on Instagram Live, and that once I was on Instagram Live, I was gonna get questions from the comments, and that was gonna inspire what I was gonna talk about for the last like 3 or so minutes of this vlog. Instead, what happened was that Stitches showed up. Stitches, you know, the guy with the crazy ass face tattoos, brick in your face, all those crazy anthems, dude from Florida. Well, he showed up in the chat along with a lot of other people. I don't really go on Instagram Live almost ever, so my Instagram being Adam22. So when I went on, I got a lot of people in there in the chat, and so I did the split screen thing, which I had never done before. I did that with Hakeem and Xavier Wolf for a little while, and then Stitches was hitting me up, so I started another one, and I went on there and just talked to Stitches, and I wanted to save the video file, but like I didn't click save like as soon as it was done. So it just didn't save. So then I tried to use the screen recorder on Apple, like on here. You can use the screen recording now. You just Google this. It's like if you have the new operating system, you can record your screen. It's really, really nice. But somehow I sat here and I rewatched the entire fucking stream just like so that I could, you know, record it. And the audio cut out like halfway through. So I don't know. Is this a problem that other people are having with Apple's fancy fucking new screen recording software? I don't know. Either way, if you want to go watch my Instagram live story and see me talk to Stitches, which I'm going to be completely honest, it wasn't exactly the most interesting conversation anyway. It was pretty obvious that his wife was there. So he was kind of holding his tongue. I was trying to get him to talk about like crazy stuff, threesomes and all this stuff. And he's like, my wife's right here. And he said his wife got mad at him for being raunchy with me. Anyway, yeah. What the fuck am I now? What am I talking about now? I don't know. All right, so I was just on live and Stitches was in the comments, and I've never actually met Stitches, but I have DM'd with him. So I just got out of it and then I added him and now, oh, there he is. Okay, adding Stitches. For everything, today's my day to Stitches. Hey!
What's up, bro?
Damn, this is a big moment for white people all over the world. What's going on?
Just chilling over here at the crib. How about you?
I'm just chilling. Long ass day. This is cool, like for us to meet like this for the first time, as opposed to like when we actually end up doing the interview, you know?
Yeah.
So what you want?
Cocaine? Nah, I'm joking.
No, you're off that?
Yeah, I don't do that shit no more.
That's good. I can't really handle that anymore. I seen Riff Raff the other day and he was super sober. That was nice.
That's good.
Because I know the old Riff Raff that was, like, probably on, like, more cocaine than, like, Stitches might have been at a certain point.
Ah. No way. No way.
I'll take your word for it.